Well, from the Carolina backwoods all the way to the White House, Andrew Jackson lived a remarkable life. But it was his heroics on the battlefield that actually saved America.
Over there were thousands of British troops. What they wanted was over there. That was New Orleans. What they wanted to control was over there, the Mississippi. What's at stake? The future of the country. What did Andrew Jackson do? Win.
Joining us right now is the author of Andrew Jackson and the Miracle of New Orleans, Fox and Friends Zone, Brian Kilmeade. Gets a little cold here in New York. Suddenly he's off to Orlando. Look at that.
Brian, it's weird when we get a card that says your name on it. Brian Kilmeade, co-host of Fox and Friends. Steve said, how do we pronounce his last name?
Well, listen, I just think you got to be in your best behavior because, you know, I'm judging you. First off, I don't need a card today, and Jamaica people are very nice, as well as the hair division. But that was 110 degrees shooting that in New Orleans. Here it's 85 and humid. There it's 12. But the whole thing is finally going to air. The special is going to air, Andrew Jackson, Hero Under Fire. When we started the book 2 years ago, this was nothing to do with the news. I just thought it was going to be a great history piece. I had no idea how similar this host of The Apprentice would be to Andrew Jackson, who ends up in the Oval Office. And then both get under fire for some certain things they say. Both are very similar candidates for what they did. But that battle in particular is where Andrew Jackson made his name.
So, Brian, what is the difference between the book and the special?
Well, the book is the Battle of New Orleans, and we lay out the whole thing, how it happened and how we pulled it off. The special is going to be Andrew Jackson, Hero Under Fire. We go to Jackson Square, where there's a group of people who want that statue down. The guy who saved New Orleans for the future president of the United States, they want his statue down. Then we go in front of the White House, and we go into the White House, and we talk about the similarities between President Trump as well as President Jackson, and why Ronald Reagan, FDR, Harry Truman, especially Abraham Lincoln, looked to Andrew Jackson as a prototype and made the decisions he made. In fact, here is one of the questions I posed was how Jackson and Trump, when they took the presidency, how they were both under fire going in and then once they got the job. If you want to take a listen.
He'd read the paper, and then he'd write comments in the margins. This is good or bad. Or there's one article in particular that really took him to task, and there's a great big X through the whole article in ink.
Donald Trump brags on being a counterpuncher. Well, so was Andrew Jackson in battle, as you know very well, because you write about it, and in politics, and also in duels. And Andrew Jackson was in a duel with a perfect shot as his opponent. He let him shoot first. He opened his chest and said, go for it. And the perfect shot, and apparently missed. Andrew Jackson didn't even flinch. He coolly, deliberately aimed and shot the man dead. Afterwards, they learned he had been shot 2 inches from his heart. He carried that bullet till he died.
Brian, Andrew Jackson had no Twitter, but he wished he had.
Right. And he also used to pick up the newspapers, make marks, and get a hold of those reporters, much like I think the current president today. I also think it's interesting to see back then they settled their disputes by shooting each other. Just anyone who thinks that we're in an unprecedented situation in terms of bare-fisted politics, this is kind of mellow compared to the way it used to be. But again, both of them do not know how to back down from a fight. And now Jackson's presidency is being hit. He's not perfect. The Trail of Tears he's responsible for. He had slaves. No one could excuse that. He was a person of his time. We understand that. But again, evaluating his presidency today, the way he lived 200 years ago, is forgetting the fact that he was the most famous man in America, who was orphaned at 13 years old. This guy should have been a criminal. He should have been a vagrant. He should have been a no-name. Instead, he was a congressman, a senator, attorney general, a legendary general, and a two-term president. That, to me, and we stumbled onto this, that's what America's about. Although now we have university systems and we have social programs. Back then, they said, basically, you're on your own. You have no family. You're brothers are dead, your mom passed away, your dad died before you were born. Good luck, son. And he said, fine, I'll do the best I can. And man, I thought he did pretty good.
An extraordinary American. That's why you wrote the book on it. And in fact, you're going to be later today on December 7th at 1 o'clock at Books a Million in Sanford, Florida. Then at 5 o'clock this afternoon, you're going to be at the Barnes & Nobles at the Villages.
And then tomorrow,
tomorrow is our base
at noon at the Kravitz Center for the Performing Arts in West Palm Beach. And of course,
all right.
It's going to be special. On this program.
And the special is Sunday night, 8 o'clock and 11 o'clock. And, Brian, I think it's great that you have brought this to light for so many people, especially the younger generation that doesn't know anything about Andrew Jackson.
Like me.
And now we will. No, you're not. You're not.